right, all right, all right. Hey, good to see all the peoples. I'm not seeing any people, but it's good to imagine that you're out there. Oh, you know what? Here, let me do this. Let me take all this shit out of my pockets so I don't make it easier to play. All right, look at that. Now I can play a lot easier. All right, so let me, I'm just gonna start off by playing some songs. Hold on, crap. Sorry. I'm supposed to be muted. Okay. Let me do this. Let me first let the world know that that this is happening.
Now I'm thinking of something.
Hey. Something blue. I'm assuming that's Steve, right? No, hey, Blue. Good to see you, man. Right on. Hey, Paper Cat. Good to see you, brother. Okay. So what am I doing? Okay, let me don't need that one. Okay, there we go. All right. So I'm gonna play a handful of songs that I'm hoping to use to warm up my voice and get the fingers limbered up. I got a little chance to practice this morning, but
drunken tirades, the slamming of doors, the things that you say that hurt me and hurt me some more. Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? The way that you scream and shove me away. The insult you hurl as tomorrow becomes today. Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? 'Cause I just want to love you. Oh, please don't make it so hard. Oh, I just want love you. Oh, please don't make it so hard. Fury and rage that then turns to tears, the weeping that then becomes a litany of unrealized fears. Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? The glass is half empty, but it's always, always near full. Booze is a constant that you can never quite rule. Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? Can't you be cool? 'Cause I just want to love you. Oh, please don't make it so hard. Oh, I just want
Yeah, so that one I'm definitely, you know, like it's funny because I'm now working on modes and kind of mastering those. Most of my guitar playing is focused on those and not on all my new stuff. But good to see you, Dick's out. And wait, let me see who else there was. Let me pop out the chat real quick. So I can read it a little bit better. But yeah, man. So good to see everybody. I saw Joff is here. I haven't seen you in a while, brother. Let me see. Dick's out and paper cut and blue front. Bobcat, right on, man. Good to see you. There was a couple other people that said hello. Sorry about this. I didn't have my screen fully set up properly. But Cheeseburger 6917, good to see you, man. I'm gonna play a couple more. Oh, so this one was a request yesterday. Dick's out. Hey, Stefan, good to see you, man. Right on. Dick's out requested this one, and I wasn't able to play it, but now I can. So it goes like this. No, that's right.
Sometimes you wake up broken, and the thought of pressing on seems so fucking pointless, girl, 'cause all your joy is gone. Well, sister, I must tell you, I've been where you are, love. The pain you feel, it hurts me too, and the hurts keep stacking up. Don't you lose faith, my dear, don't you give up our hope. I will be right here. Hold on, and I will hold on too. I'll hold on for you, and we'll hold on together. Together, hold on, and I will hold on too. I'll hold on for you, and we'll hold on together. Sometimes you feel unwelcome, unwanted and unloved, and there's no place that feels like home, and there's no God above. I know that so sick loneliness, I know it all too well, and even in the company of friends, you're in a private hell. Don't you lose faith, my dear, don't you give up our hope. I will be right here. Hold on, and I will hold. Together, hold on, and I will hold on to. I'll hold on for you, and we'll hold on together.
Oh no. So yeah, right on. Dick's out, man. I'll get into fine working fighting shape very soon. Let me save that one. Hold on. Let me lyrics and chords. Hold on. And yeah, right on. Thank you, Bobcat. Yeah, that's that one. It's so crazy. Like, it's funny because I've been kind of hanging out with some new people here in Austin, and a friend of mine was like talking about how the fact that like she was saying like she's like, man, your stuff is like really dark, you know? And I was like, yeah, you know, I guess because when I'm feeling good, right? When everything's kicking ass. I'm compelled to enjoy those moments and live them. You know, I don't write about them. I'm outliving them, you know? A lot of my music is just, is me kind of externalizing all of the bad stuff and the bad times and the anger and the vitriol. And then of course there's other stuff. I mean, the thing is I do use it as a means to like, divest myself of, so like, just to externalize some of that, you know, some of that, that, yes, like jelly. Anyway, I'm gonna open up the request line. I'm gonna still play a few more that kind of like strike my fancy, and then I'll play your guys' requests. I'm gonna play this is a new one. This is one I wrote a few days ago. And this is another one that kind of falls in that same vein. This is a buddy of mine is going through a really tough time, and so I wrote a song trying to identify with what he's going through. Not in any way trying to make peace with it. Well, I guess there is a little bit of reconciliation, but here you go. It goes like this.
I know you're hurting now. I know the blood is flowing through you and out your wounds. I know you're struggling now. I know the devil's deep inside you. The devil's got you down, and she's never letting go. Oh, and you don't really want to let her go, and she's never backing down. She will always be around. Oh, the devil's got you down. I know you're breaking down. I can hear the pain inside you. Chained and shackled now, and there's no backing down from this fight. The devil's holding tight, and she's never letting go. Oh, and you don't really want to let her go, and she's never backing down. She will always be around. Oh, the devil's got you down. So raise a glass and celebrate the moments that we share. 'Cause every time we turn around, someone isn't there. The devil's in the details, and the details own our hearts. The devil's come to tear us apart.
There we go.
I know you're in such pain. I know you can't escape the sorrow. Such sorrow. I know it's killing you. I know you want a different body, a different circumstance. But the devil's got your head, and she's never ever ever letting go. And she's never backing down. She will always be around. Oh, the devil's got you down. So raise a glass and celebrate the moments that we share. 'Cause every time you turn around, someone isn't there. The devil's in the details, and the details zone our hearts. The devil's come to tear us apart. I know you're hurting now. I know the blood is flowing through you and out your wounds. I know you're struggling now. I know the struggle's deep inside you. The devil's got you down, and she's never letting go. Oh, and you don't really want to let her go, and she's never backing down. She will always be around. Oh, the devil's got you.
It's funny. I realize that I have over my life. I keep writing songs where they don't have a real resolution. Like they're meant to leave you going, wait, that's the end of the song. What's going on? You know. And that's definitely one of those. I'm gonna play a couple more, and then I will. So Ron Stoppable. hey, right on, dicks out. Right on, brother. Let me think. So what am I looking for? Hey, Richie Mama, good to see you. Awesome. I want to do this one. Just because I want to just keep. I played it yesterday, and the finger picking was a little bit rough. So I want to get this one, and then I'll start playing the request. So this is called My Doppelgangers and Me. Okay, it goes like this. Wait. Say your life flashes right before your eyes, just before you die, it's true. And this is it, it's happening right now, it's flashing right in front of you. Have you had the time of your life? For this is a time of your life. Each decision that you make creates another you that went a different way. And in some other place, there's another me that did it all okay. Another universe's perfect me. And I'm just a very flawed copy. Things I do are a mystery to me. It's a miracle I breathe at all. I wanna live, or at least I think I do. But most every choice I make is flawed. Have you had the time of your life? For this is a time of your life. Each decision that you make creates another you that went a different way. And in some other place, there's another me that did it all okay. Another universe's perfect me. And I'm just a very flawed copy.
You'll never write well if you're dying. Yeah, I'd say it's probably. Greatest fear, actually. It's something all men before you have done, all men will do. Have you ever made love to a truly great woman?
Actually, my fiance is pretty sexy.
And when you make love to her, you feel true and beautiful passion, and you, for at least that moment, lose your fear of death.
No, that doesn't happen.
I believe that love that is true and real creates a respite from death. All cowardice comes from not loving or not loving well, which is the same thing. When the man who is brave and true looks death squarely in the face, like some rhino hunters I know, or Belmonte, who's truly brave, it is because they love with sufficient passion to push death out of their minds until the return that it does to all men. And then you must make really good love.
Have you had the time of your life? For this is the time of your life. Each decision that you make creates another you that went a different way. And in some other place, there's another me that did it all okay. Another universe's perfect me. I'm just a very flawed copy.
Yeah, the Doppel, that audio is from a movie called Midnight in Paris. It's a Woody Allen movie. It might be my favorite Woody Allen movie, which is really strange because he's not in it. There's a fantastic component to it, and so the Owen Wilson character plays a writer. He plays a Hollywood writer, he's a screenwriter, and he really aspires to be a novelist. And he's doing a little vacation in Paris, with his fiancée. And he gets transported back in time to the 1920s in Paris, which is I don't know how much you know about literary history, but that was a very vibrant period where there were a lot of American expatriates that, like, Henry Miller was there, and Ernest Hemingway, and F. Scott Fitzgerald, and Zoe Fitzgerald, and Jean Reese, and there's this crazy group of people that were writing, Anais Nin and so he goes back, and that's actually him talking to Ernest Hemingway. So Ernest Hemingway is the guy saying all the, you know, and the guy that plays Ernest Hemingway is pretty spot on from the way I envision Ernest Hemingway being from his writing, you know. Mike, which fans would you call annoying? There's a bunch of painters and it was Paris at that point in time was a pretty amazing place to be. Certain fans will kind of ask a lot of time, will try to ask for a lot of my time. And unfortunately, I don't have the time to give very often, and that can get frustrating for me because I wanna be the kind of person that someone can reach out and be like, hey, I need a hand. I carry around dollar bills with me everywhere I go now because whenever I see a homeless person with a sign that says help, anything, particularly if it says help, then I try to give him a dollar, because the thing is, I don't want to be the kind of person that refuses help from someone that's actively asking for it. But at the same time, the thing is that, like, it does get really taxing, right? When people are like, hey, can you write a song for me for this thing at this time? And I need you, like, I've definitely had to define boundaries over the course of my music career as I'm, you know, as my life has progressed, but whatever. Okay, so let me play. I'll play Pissin' and Kissin', and then we'll. So this is the bio break song that I wrote with the chat, and this is a very, very weird song. It's awesome, but the lyrics are part me, part chat, and then yeah, but it goes like this. If you sprinkle. When you tinkle, be a sweetie and I got the tempo wrong. If you sprinkle when you tinkle, be a sweetie and wipe the CD, won't you, darling? Pass the Charmin. I only wipe it to ply, it reminds me of the softness of your eye, your blue or brown eye. Don't let the noises make you blush, just be a dear and push to flush, oh won't you? Don't be a prude, do your duty, don't you know you're such a bathroom beauty? Drop your lipstick on the floor, lose your Levi's, lock the door, oh baby, you drive me crazy. Spread the linens, let's do some sinning. Never mind the pissing, let's do some kissing. It's what I'm missing. But you just shut the door on me. I guess you really need to pee, oh don't you? I guess you gotta make a duty. Don't you know you're such a bathroom beauty? Oh,
thinking of you as I shake my pickle, watching the trickle leaving from a saber. What's that vapor? I wish I had a Japanese bidet just to make everything okay down there. It's really not fair. Darling, I'm sick of wiping up, so much wiping I've had enough. Oh darling, don't be a prude, do your duty. Don't you know you're such a bathroom beauty? Oh, 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 now we're both evacuated. Come on now, let's get naked, darling. There's no harm in butt cheeks on the porcelain sugar. Let me feel you shake, let me feel you shiver. Let me deliver 3,000 megatons of loving. I'm just glad you're not my cousin, baby. Like last time. And that's just the end. Oh, terrible, terrible. We're terrible people, you guys. I just have to say. All right, let's get this. Let's get, I'll start playing some requests. Awesome, Mary. Good, hey, good to see you. Good to see you, Jamie. Right on. all right. Hey, Steve. Yeah, it's a silly tune. It's definitely a silly tune. Hey, Luda Peta. Hey. All right. So yeah, Luda talked about. Here, hold on. There you go, brother. All right. Okay. All right. So this is a heartfelt. This is a genuinely, like every now and again, I write a song that is genuinely. It's a little bit broken, but genuinely. You know, a genuinely sweet tune, and this is one of them. I really like this tune. I don't play it that often. Some days it feels like I'm broken, like nothing I do is right. And all of my silly decisions seem to unravel and unwind. But I know that's not true, because I have you, and you are the star, guiding me back to safe harbor in your heart. Some days I feel like a failure, like I'll never get quite there, like all of the songs that I'm writing are so much empty air. But I know that's alright. Know that's alright, because tonight you are with me, and that my love is reason enough to sing. So let me sing a song to you. Let it be simple. Let it be pure. Let me sing my broken heart, and let a loving be the cure. Oh. Some days I feel like I'm stumbling, like I can't bear to stand, like the weight of all of my trouble has me pinned and unmanned. But I know that's not true, because I have you, and you are my love. And sweetheart, you give me strength enough. So let me sing a song to you. Let it be simple. Let it be pure. Let me sing my broken heart, and let a loving be the cure.
la 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 la. Some days I feel like a failure, like I'll never get quite there. Like all of the songs that I'm writing are so much empty air. But I know that's alright, because tonight you are with me, and that my love is reason enough to sing. There you go. Yeah, man. So yeah, that's a sweet song. I like that. You know, like every now and again, I write a song without any real tongue in cheek. It's silly, you know, like every now and again, I occasionally let one of those fall out. Hey, Eric, good to see you, man. I realized that you commented when I was talking about Paris at Midnight, but I didn't say hello. Good to see you, man. Oh, great. Hey, thank you, Richie Mama. Awesome. Thank you so much. And thank you, Mary. Thank you. All right, Bobcat, get your food on. So this next song, I don't normally like talking about kind of like the motivations behind songs, because I think that like that you guys, you know, I don't want to take that away from you. Like, you know, like because when you hear a song, hey, Lenina, awesome. You put meaning into it, right? You get to invest your own meaning in the song. And if I tell you my meaning, then oftentimes that will trump your meaning. And I don't want to do that because that sort of ruins the purpose of art, right? So, but this song definitely was written for friends of mine who kind of walked away from something that we had spent years and years building. And it kind of broke my heart. And so this is why I wrote this song for it. I'm too afraid to ever try to kill myself. I'm too scared of not being around. But I don't know why I'm holding on so desperately, 'cause nothing is building, instead it's tumbling down. I feel like the end of a song, oh, I'm fading out. Certainly once everyone sang along, but the last refrain was oh so long ago, and no one cares for a song gone on too long. So let's say goodbye, remember me to your family. Oh, hold on tight to the memory of when we used to be larger than life, like demigods at a barking all, with fire in our hearts and stars in our eyes. We were fucking unstoppable. So let's say goodbye, remember me to your family. Oh, hold on tight to the memory of what used to be. I know you're done, you've moved on, and you left me here. But sometimes when you see me, oh, you smile. And you think to yourself, at least he's still fighting the good fight. But I'm here to say, you can go straight to hell. So let's say goodbye, remember me to your family. Oh, hold on tight to the memory of when we used to be thicker than thieves and larger than life, like demigods at a barking bell, with fire in our hearts and stars in our eyes. We were fucking unstoppable. So let's say goodbye, remember me to your family. Oh, hold on tight to the memory of what used to be. Never burn down. I'll sing it again.
again, I'll sing it out loud. Oh, the fire will never go out, the fire will never go down. I'll sing it again, I'll sing it out loud. La, 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 la. So let's say goodbye. Remember me to your family. Oh, hold on tight to the memory of when we used to be. Thicker than thieves and larger than life, like demigods at a Bacchanal. With fire in our hearts and stars in our eyes, we were fucking unstoppable.
That's very funny. I actually do use Mrs. Baird's bread. I actually did price out exactly the cost of buying a tub of jelly and a tub of peanut butter and a loaf of Mrs. Baird's large sliced white bread. I was like, well, I might as well be specific. Hey, and thank you so much, Stoic. Yeah, that's and thank you, Blue. I thank you, man. You're very kind, brother. Yeah, dude. Thank you. I often these little financial these little donation goals are just me being silly, you know. But the thing is, obviously this is what I do to make a living, you know. And the amazing thing has been, despite the fact that when everybody migrated to streaming, it totally erased a significant portion of my annual income. Me doing Twitch and doing this has been an awesome replacement, and I love it because it keeps me playing my songs, and it keeps me thank you for being here first and foremost. Thank you for just spending your time with me and hanging out, because that's awesome. But those of you that do donate a little cash, kick down a little tip here and there, it's always welcome, and I really do appreciate it. So thank you so much, Blue. I would say if there's songs that you want me to play, I would play them for you, but I already do. There you go. If there's another song you want to hear, brother, let me know and I will do it. That's very funny. Cannabis. I'm Mike TV from the band Get Set Go. If you just look down, like it, I only play my own stuff, man. I've got 12 full length records in stores. I've got EPs and side project albums. I've got really scores and scores of studio demos and outtakes and stuff like that. So I'm so sorry, brother. I can only play my own stuff. But here's one. This is a sing along. This is a sing along. This one is basically, thank you so much, amigo. So this one is a sing along. So your part is gonna be, let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. So basically, where I really need you to sing that is at the very end of the song. The very end of the song. I'm gonna need you to sing that through. Oh, hey, Elix, dude, thank you so much, man. Yeah, well, that's all right, great. Thank you. Now I'm eating peanut butter and jelly. So I am gonna go. I literally am gonna go pick up the kazoo tomorrow. Today, I'm going to Straight Music to pick up new strings, yes! And I'm gonna pick up the kazoo. Yes! And I think I'm gonna head to H-E-B. I'll grab myself some peanut butter and jelly. That's very kind of you guys. So, all right, so this one, thank you so much, Elix. Thank you, brother. Yeah, man, it's awesome. That's very kind of you. I'm gonna need you to sing all at the outro, at the very end, when I say keep going, I need you to sing all the way to the end of the song. Here we go.
So very soon, oh, you know that it will be okay. Just just let it slip away. What can we do? Let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Oh, you know that we are getting older, but we are getting better looking. Close your eyes, another new surprise, another something wicked. It's a cooking. Oh, you know that it will be just fine. You know it's just your mind that you can still. Oh, you know that when it's broken down, we make the newest sounds and then we kill. Let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Oh, you know that when it's broken down, we make the newest sounds and then we kill. Looking, close your eyes, another new surprise, another something wicked, is it cooking? Oh, you know that it will be alright, you know we'll feel alright, so very soon,
your part's coming up.
Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do?
Here we go.
Let's take a walk to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright. So very soon
here, keep that going.
Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk.
Right on. Hey, thank you, Cannabis. Thank you so much, man. That, like, seriously. And I saw. Let me actually read the message real quick. It was. Oh wait, hold on. Okay, brother, the music business is hard in Hong Road, all the best from England. Oh, right on, man. Thank you. Yeah. And it is, you know, I definitely make my musical path a lot more difficult than it needs be, but you know, but that's just to protect kind of like, I want music to always be joyful and always be fun and always be awesome. Oh yeah. Hey, thank you, Elix. All right. So in 2008, my band Get Set Go, we'd put out four albums. First album did terrible. Second album did pretty well, and we you know, it got us on the national map, and we were on, at this point in time, iTunes had an alternative top 100 albums, and we made it to the middle of the pack, and then we stayed there for like 8 or 9 or 10 weeks. It was crazy. And we toured the country, and there was press talking about us, and it was a really, really good time. It felt like, yay, we're finally making marks, you know, in the national scene. And Grey's Anatomy was licensing a bunch of our stuff at that point in time. And then the next record was, I believe, a little bit mismanaged in terms of the rollout. And then the next record, I think was even our record label just kept scaling back the amount of money they were putting into the albums, and so by 2008, I was like, well, that's my music career, it's fucking over, you know, this is why I believe I'm on the earth, and so it was just, I was like, so I wrote an album a side project album. The album, the band is called I Give Up. So the band is called I Give Up, and the album is called Nobody Cares. And it's a really, really dark album. And this song is called The Secret of My Success. And this song basically outlines this song basically outlines my entire perspective at that point in time. So here goes. Oh yeah, here, let me do that right now. Hold on. Let me add Luda right here. Right, hold on real quick. Currency. Luda Peta. Okay. So yeah, it should be working right now, man. Or you might take a minute or two, but yeah, you should be all set. Here we go. You try, but you fail. You try, but you fail. But you pick yourself up and you dust yourself off and you give it another go. Oh, you try, but you fail. So at what point do you give up? Oh, at what point do you give in? Oh, at what point is enough enough? I give up. You work like a dog and you spend all you got and you hope and you pray and you give it a shot but you fail. But you do it again because all of your friends say they love what you do, so keep doing it, man, you can't fail. So you pick yourself up and you dust yourself off and you give it another go. Oh, you try, but you fail. So at what point do you give up? Oh, at what point do you give in? Oh, at what point is enough enough? I give up. I'm so filled with doubt, I wish I'd never started out. I'm done, I'm finally through, I guess that it's up to you to carry on. Ooh. I give up. So yeah, so that song, it's funny. And then really truthfully, I tried giving up music. So that was released in 2008. 2009, I moved up to the Bay Area. I wrote 9 songs. I was like, fuck it, I'm done with music. And then I broke up with my long-term girlfriend. And I was like, fuck this. I'm heading back to Los Angeles and I'm going to write me as many songs and as many albums as I possibly can. And ever since then, so since 2010, I'm like, fuck it. I'm now no longer after significant album sales and significant success. I'm now after, I want to put out 40 or 50 albums by the time I die. Like, I just want to have so much music that people are like, well, we can't even get through all this music. We can't even listen to all of his music. It's impossible. That's my objective. So, okay. Let's see. So, okay. Well, all right. So it's now, Dick's out. I'm going to wait a little bit to play Wait, because that's sort of one of the hits. And I usually like to use the pre-show warm-up time to play songs that I don't play that often, you know. And then the main show, which starts in 10 minutes. I'll play it within the next 10 minutes. Just want to let you know. So and what was it? Blue. Is Blue still here? I think he's on his phone. He just commented. There you go. All right, hey, good to see you, brother. All right, so let's do a reggae mix of 100 Locks. Yeah. I don't do the ska, like the ska style picking, the reggae. Yeah, I don't do the ups. I would have to listen to a ska beat to approximate the thing that. So yeah, unfortunately. That's something I will work on at some point in time. I have no real interest in a lot of reggae because it's not a genre I've ever really gotten super into. Not that I don't like it. It's, you know, like, I just haven't really explored it too much. So I haven't taken the time to sort out how to play it. But I'll do 100 Locks, the normal way. How about that? And no, I actually mix and all my, I mix and master all my own stuff, Pixie Pixel. So thank you, man, though. Bum 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 down bum 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 down bum 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 bum. She cuts herself beneath her clothes, a secret wound that no one knows. She likes the way she hurts herself, it makes her feel like nothing else. Bam, 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 bam. She never talks to anyone. She hides away, abhors the sun. She keeps her heart within a box, protected with 100 locks. It's true. It's true. She walks nude throughout her room. She bears the scars of countless wounds. They multiply upon her flesh. Some are old and others fresh. It's true. And only darkness shines. She loves the night when only the darkness shines. She loves the night, the starless and the moonless night, when all of the lights are gone and only darkness shines. She loves the night when only the darkness shines. She cuts herself beneath her clothes, a secret wound that no one knows. She likes the way she hurts herself. Like nothing else. Bam, 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 bam. She never talks to anyone. She hides away, abhors the sun.
starless and the moon is dark and all of the lights are gone. And only daggers shine, she loves the night. The starless and the moon is dark, all of the lights are gone. And only darkness shines.
See you, Richie's mom. Have a great day. Thank you. Yeah, thanks for being here. Thanks for being a part of the show. I think there was something I was going to say that was predicated on the, oh yeah. Is there anybody else? I'm going to add a couple other people. If you like the show, if we know your name, then definitely come, let me know and we will, and I will add you to the regulars list. I'm going to do that to Dick's out real quick. Give me 1 second. Currency. Where is it? There we go. Okay. Is there anybody else in the chat that we feel needs to be added to the regulars list? Does anybody know? Yeah, Blue. Yeah, it's just the whole thing. The whole currency thing is just screwed up. The bot is just screwed up. But Yes. If you're here for the free hugs, it's hugs from me. It's hugs from everybody else. There you go. Guy licking Gilf anus. You had a question. What were you gonna ask, man? We've got about 3 minutes. We got 3 minutes until the primary show time. What do we want to do as a sing along? Somebody was saying something about yesterday. They're like, why isn't this song a sing along? Which one was that? Hey, thank you so much. Matt Smith, 25. Thank you so much for the follow, man. I'm glad you're digging the show. And thank you for being here. I don't know. It's Raining Grandmas. If that's an actual song, then more power to them, the people that came up with the name for that song. If it's not an actual song, then I would love to write that song, because It's Raining Grandmas is a fucking great idea, great title. Okay. Let me see. What do we want to play? What do we want to do for the opening sing-along? There was a song yesterday where someone was saying, was it you, Steve? Was Steve saying that? Right on, man. You as well. Yeah. Thanks for dropping by. Sorry. Yeah. I unfortunately I only know my own stuff. Music makes me want to die. You know what? Actually, as an opening sing-along, why don't we do So You're Gonna Die as the opening sing-along? Cause I think that's a fun one. Everybody's gonna die. Don't it make you wanna cry? So yeah, let's do that one as the opening sing-along. Let's get the show up and running just a little bit early. How about that? What's that, Elix? Everyone get moving. Yeah, that one. Yeah, that's true. All right. Well, all right. So why don't we put it to a vote? What do you guys, we can do Everybody Get Moving or So You're Gonna Die as the opening sing-along. Everybody Get Moving. The bridge is titanic. Like the, okay. Everyone Get Moving. All right, cool. Yeah. All right. Then yeah. Let's do it. Yeah, you know, you're right, Blue. You're right. That one is a good sing along as well. All right. 1 second. Let me get this queued up, and then we'll get the song up and running. And we'll get the show up and running. All right, here, let's everyone get done. Yeah. The mashup. Everyone get dying. Come on, fuckers. Everybody die. All right, let me give him 1 second. I'll be back in just a moment. I'm going to mute myself just for...